Let's take one example of DC generator. An 8 pole lap wound DC generator has 960 conductors. A flux of 50 milliweber per pole and is driven at 500 RPM. Calculate the EMF. So first we should find out what are the things given. Phi is given, it is 50 milliweber. Z is given, it is 960. N is given, 500 RPM. Pole is 8. And it is mentioned that it is lap winding, so A is equal to P, which is equal to 8. Solution for this, E is equal to, okay, it is given by, E is given by P phi N Z upon 60 A. P is given, P is 8, phi is given, 50 milliweber, N is given, 500 RPM, Z is given 960, A is given 8. So, putting the values here, we find the answer is 400 volt. Let's take one example of a shunt generator. A 20 kilowatt, 200 volt shunt generator has an armature resistance of 0.5 ohm. And a shunt field resistance of 200 ohm. Calculate the power developed in the armature. Okay, so these are the things which are given. Now we have to find out the solution. So the solution here, IA is equal to IL plus ISH. It is a shunt generator. So armature current will be load current plus shunt current. So power delivered to the load is V into IL. And power delivered to the armature is EG into IA. So first we'll find out I2. I2 is P upon V. Power is this 100 ampere. Now ISH is 1 ampere. IA we can calculate. It is given by this. Sorry, this is IL. So armature current will be 101 ampere. EG is equal to V plus IA, RA. Put the values here. We will find this. Power developed is EG into IA. So, calculating this, we can get this 20.71 kilowatt. We will see an example of DC motor. Determine developed torque and shaft torque of 220 volt 4 pole series motor with 800 conductors wave connected supplying a load of 8.2 kilowatt by taking 45 ampere from the mains. The flux per pole is 25 milliweber and its armature current resistance is 0.6 ohm. Okay, the things which are given is phi, RA, Z, P and A is equal to 2. So, the formula for torque is this. Substituting the values, we get the answer this. EB is V minus IA, RA. Putting the values here, we get this. EB is phi, Z and P upon A. From this, EB we can calculate N because the rest of the things are given and EB we have calculated here. So N comes out to be this. Also 2 by N TSH is given by this and TSH we will get using this relation.